Hello YouTube family, welcome to another video in SAP CPI adapters. In this video, I'm going to talk about HTTP adapter. We try to cover various aspects of HTTP adapter in SAP CPI. We will cover what is HTTP adapter, how do you configure HTTP adapter in SAP CPI, and we'll talk about some of the important questions that you can get in interview discussion regarding HTTP adapter. Let's begin. We use HTTPS adapter in SAP CPI to send and receive messages using HTTPS protocol. It is based on HTTP adapter, but with additional security features such as SSL, TSL encryption, and client authentication. You need this adapter when you want to exchange data securely and reliably with receiver systems that supports HTTPS. For example, you can use this HTTPS adapter to call RESTful web services, access audit APIs, or send messages to cloud applications. You can use the HTTPS adapter to connect to different applications that offer HTTPS endpoints. For example, we can integrate SAP Ariba, SAP SuccessFactors, Salesforce, Microsoft Dynamics CRM, Amazon Web Services, and many applications by using HTTP adapter. You can also use HTTPS adapter to communicate with other CPI tenants or custom applications that expose HTTPS interfaces. Let's quickly talk about the configuration of sender HTTPS adapter and receiver HTTP adapter. On sender HTTPS side, you have to provide the address. Basically, address is nothing but the URL of the HTTP system that you want to connect to. It is a combination of host and port details of your remote system. Under the authorization, you can see client certificate or user role. In simpler terms, when use client certificate option in the sender adapter, what happens is the system verifies the identity of the sender by checking issuer and the subject that is received in the inbound message. In this option, you always have to select one or more client certificates by using this add option. When you add a client certificate in SAP CPI, you can always see subject DN and issuer DN. Here, DN stands for distinguished name. The second option is user role. When you choose this option, the inbound authorization is always checked based on user role. The default role is esbmessaging.send. By using this role, you can process messages on SAP CPI tenant. The last option we have is CSRF protected. This is by default selected. Actually, this option prevents cross-site request forgery, which is a malicious online attack. Such attacks exposes user content without their authorization, so this should be always selected. In the other tab, we have conditions. In the conditions, you can mention the body size of the inbound message. If your inbound message exceeds the size of the given limit, the message will be rejected automatically and an error message will be generated. Let's quickly talk about the receive side HTTP adapter configuration. To start with, you always need to enter the address. Basically, it is the host and port name of the target application to which you want to send the messages from SAP CPI. In the query field, you have to enter the query string. Please note, query string must not be entered in the addressed field. If needed, this query string can be a static value or it can be externalized by using a variable. In the proxy type, you can select either internet or on-premise. If you select internet, the data routing happens via the internet. You can choose on-premise when you want to exchange the messages within the on-premise systems. When you choose on-premise as a proxy type, you need to enter the location ID. Basically, location ID is a unique identifier for the cloud connector instance. Under the method, you can choose the HTTP action that you must perform on the target system. This can be post, delete, dynamic, get, head, put, patch, and trace. You can use dynamic to dynamically change the method by using a variable substitution. When you use method get, delete, head, or dynamic, you can have an option to send the body to target system. When you select dynamic as a method, then you have an option to enter the expression that specifies the HTTP method. In authentication dropdown, you can select the authentication mode with which your SAP CPI tenant authenticates itself against the target system. From the dropdown, you can choose basic, OAuth 2 client credentials, none, principal propagation. You can choose none when the target system does not require any authentication. You can choose Basic when you want to use a user ID and password to authenticate SAP CPI to the target system. In real-time production scenarios, we don't use None or Basic options. We either use OAuth 2 or Principal Propagation. You can use Principal Propagation authentication mode only if the proxy type is on-premise. When you choose proxy type as Internet, you would get two additional authentication options, which are Client Certificate and OAuth 2 SAML Bearer Assertion. If you select authentication mode Basic, OAuth 2 Client Credentials, or OAuth 2 SAML Bearer Assertion, you need to enter the user credential. Then you have timeout parameter, which indicates the maximum time that the tenant waits for a response before terminating the message processing. Additionally, we have flags like throw exception on failure, attach error details on failure, in case of failure, what is the mechanism? So these two flags define that property. And you can also enter some header details like request headers, response headers. In the request header settings, you can define the custom headers that you want to send to the target system. In the response header section, you can enter the custom headers that you would expect as a response from the target system. In interview, you can expect some questions around the authentication modes. What is the recommended authentication mode on the sender side? And what are the recommended modes for on the receiver side? And what is the best practice? And how did you handle the certificates? And what are the common issues that you faced while working with HTTP adapter? And how did you handle the huge volumes? For example, you are getting huge message from the source, or you need to send huge message to the target. How did you handle that situation? And what parameters have you used to customize it? And they might also ask you about how did you configure the custom headers and custom response headers. And they might also ask you what are the common issues that you faced when you're working with HTTP adapter, and how did you monitor the HTTP adapter, and how did you work with the source systems or target system teams to fix the issues with the integrations, and how did you handle the attachments. Yeah, these are the some of the questions that you can get in interview. In SAP CPI, both HTTPS and HTTP adapters are very popular. If you're working in an SAP CPI project, there is high chances that you might be working with these adapters. So I suggest familiarize with these adapters and try to understand the configuration parameters. So that's it about HTTP adapter. I hope you learned something new in this video. And if you like the video, always consider giving a like, share the video, and subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching.